Welcome to episode 3 of our Pacific Coastal series with Celebrity. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. We began our sea day with a yummy breakfast in Lumine. After breakfast, I just chilled with a spa day.
The Persian Garden is very nice. On a Millennium class ship, it is, of course, indoors. Solstice class and above, quite a number of picture windows, so it's a better view, I think a better experience. Still, the warm chairs in all the rooms, quite nice. We're on our way to the retreat lounge for a little entertainment before we go to evening chic dinner. Holly, of course, always looks amazing, so no surprise there.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Just like I serve you at home, right?
Yes, every night.
There you go.
Every night.
Alright. Yeah, it's ready. Fresca coming.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Fresca martinis taste a bit like liquid candy and are one of my favorites, though the night wasn't all about me. The camaraderie of guests and crew, and a few martinis, made for a great way to cap off the evening. We were very much looking forward to the next day when we returned to one of my favorite cities in the world. Cue Tony Bennett. San Francisco sail-ins, probably one of the more iconic sail-ins anywhere in the world you can do on a ship. That's our tug, just kind of hanging out. Must be an appointed time to come up to the ship. Either way, just an escort perhaps. Shocker, San Francisco has fog. So we are 10 minutes, I don't know what that is in miles, but on the original schedule, we're still west of the San Francisco Golden Gate Bridge, and a few people are up, some on the helipad up front. I prefer this with the lighting and the deck shot and all that good stuff. As for ambiance, well, it's pretty up here. It's not too cold, actually, but we got no bridge. We do need the fog to sort of clear. Yeah, it's all good fun. So we'll be back with you in a little bit. See whether or not we have a bridge to show you. And following, gorgeous San Francisco skyline. Pretty good rolls. We'll be right back. I can't think of a better sail in anywhere. This view never gets old. Alcatraz is historically infamous not just for its former, rather colorful prisoners, but its near inescapability, and is well worth a visit. Bread and butter of San Francisco's waterfront, certainly its warehouses. Not as prolifically used today as in years gone by, but yeah, still a significant part of their history. San Francisco has quite a bit to explore. Here's just a part of the city. The San Francisco Transit System, located directly across the street from Pier 35, is a great way to get around town. So as you can see, we're in Cheyenne, Wyoming. No, not even in Kansas anymore. We're in the heart of Chinatown in San Francisco and totally looking forward to exploring it. See a few things, maybe get a little bit of street food. We'll see how that works out.
And see what happens next.
We'll see what happens. That's one of those like unplanned go see stuff without planning and over. See you guys in a bit. Chinatown in San Francisco has the largest Chinese population outside Asia. Many 19th century Chinese were drawn by opportunities of transcontinental railroad work and the gold rush.
Most inconvenient, these cars being parked here.
Our next stop was to the Tin Hau Temple, which practices the Taoist philosophy. This temple is dedicated to Mazu, the Chinese sea goddess. In the 19th century, families would come here to pray for safe passage of other family members on their way to the United States.
This is quite an adventure. Gonna go up to the fourth floor to check out the Taoist temple from 1852. Like the staircases?
Oh yeah, they're fun.
In general, Taoism promotes simplicity and the three treasures of compassion, frugality, and humility.
That was cool. What'd you think of the temple?
Very cool. I love all the lanterns and a lot of artifacts. It's gorgeous.
Two little old ladies in there. One in particular in charge, historian, I think, giving us a lot of information about certain idols. You know, one's for health of babies. One's for just the voyage to which I didn't completely understand, because for a lot of immigrants in the mid-1850s and 1860s, people coming over here were already here. But I think what she was trying to say was that it's praying for the safety of their relatives who were about to make the boat trip over San Francisco outside of China, probably the biggest Chinese population still to today, certainly back in the mid-19th century. Very, very culturally immersive. That was cool. In a tiny little place, you gotta come here.
Our last stop in Chinatown was for lunch.
The smells here are amazing.
Hello, thank you.
Lunch was very delicious and quite fresh. We love to eat local food whenever we travel. Next, we're off to explore cable car history. The Cable Car Museum is located at the hub of San Francisco's cable car infrastructure, the actual site where the cables meet and maintenance is performed. It's a fascinating working museum and is free to enter. There is quite a bit of history to look at in this working museum. Hop on board for a ride.
Training car.
What we're gonna do is go to that round table.
Single-ended cars, like on this line, require turning on a turntable to reverse course.
We hadn't been to Chinatown before, so it was kind of cool meandering the streets and checking out the temple and trying some little delicacies.
I love the little old lady that in the temple.
Yeah, she was great. Yeah. And then from there we went over to the cable car museum. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be just a bunch of old cable cars, which they did have a few of those.
But it was a working museum.
It was working. It actually had the cables that were running the current cable cars.
Yeah, if you got...
totally cool.
If you guys didn't get that, or some of you may not, that's not just a mock-up for tourists. That's the actual hub for every single cable line for all the cars that run in... the cable cars that run in San Francisco. So, hashtag hub. It's a big deal in the cable car business. Super cool.
In fact, the entire day out was cool. San Francisco is beautiful. We can't wait to return to the city by the bay. The cruise and this video are not over. We have one more sea day before arriving in San Diego.
Just the last day. Sea day, just chilling. Have packing to do, so I've got to get that started. And I do offer, she won't let me, but
get the gear together, get the computer stuff, all the stuff that we've shot backed up and ready to go to be edited. And later tonight, we're gonna try La Petite Chef. So in fact, it's probably gonna air very soon after you're seeing this.
Our dinner was a journey through four seasons, each season a different course.
Medium rare, please. I like it when the chainsaw comes out.
You want the beast? What else? You need to do it quick. And oh yeah.
Good boy. Oh wow.
You want the beast? Only if you do something really special this time.
The next morning, we woke up in beautiful San Diego. Welcome to America's finest city. We hope you've enjoyed this video. Please consider subscribing to our channel and clicking the thumbs up button. Thank you. We have plenty of celebrity and other cruise content on our channel, so why not watch one of those videos right after this? Thank you for watching.